Hello everyone, I am Pragati. It's a pleasure to welcome you to the inaugural episode of our series In Conversation with SEMHRDN. Here we explore SEMHRD in all its essence, where we interact with students, teachers and alumni to get to know SEMHRD in and out. To kick it off, we have with us Asif, who has interned with MERSC, and Aishwarya, who has interned with Ecolab. So let's hear it from them. Hi Asif, hi Aishwarya, how are you guys today?
Hi Pragati, I'm good.
Hi Pragati, I'm good too.
So this is really nice to know. So Aishwarya, my question is for you. So what is business analytics and what sort of subject you have in your curriculum?
Okay, so let me come to the first part of the question, which is business analytics. As we all are aware that the fact that there is a huge amount of data being generated from maybe electronics and digital platforms, wherein the data can be of multiple forms like image data, video data, audio data, and maybe web searches. So the field of data science lets us explore the ability to take insights from these large unstructured data sets. So in the business world, we can say combining the knowledge of data science with the business acumen can be said as business analytics. Every corporate wants to take decisions backed up by data. Unlike the previous years where we used to take decisions based on knowledge and intuition. So at our college, we have the curriculum for business analytics designed in a very streamlined manner, wherein the subjects are aligned at a very structured format, like the basic subjects of economics, marketing, finance, operations, R, Python, database are in the first sem. And then we have the counterparts like machine learning, data mining, project management in the next sense. So it is designed in a way that you can build up on the subjects from a very initial basic level to advanced level.
That is really nice to know. Now moving on to the next question. So Asif, how was it interning with MERSC? Can you please share your experience?
Yeah, sure. So as I joined MERSC, I didn't have a lot of knowledge about the shipping industry or the logistics sector. But that's the beauty of the MERSC, that they provide you the guides or the mentors in a way that they handhold you at every step. These are the ones who have actually spent a lot of time in the industry and have been with MERSC since last 8 to 10 years. So in short, I would say that for those 2 months, it was a holistic learning experience and I gained a lot of knowledge in these sectors.
Aishwarya, can you please share your experience as well?
Yes, sure. So while interning with Ecolab, the whole internship was packed with ample of learning opportunities. I was working under the supply chain analytics division and I had got the opportunity to work on multiple projects throughout my internship duration. Which helped me actually to improve my analytical skills. So I worked on a couple of projects like the loss analysis project and the automation project. So I learned a lot in terms of domain knowledge as well as various tools used in analytics, which would surely help me to mark up my professional career in the near future.
It is indeed great to know that you had a kind of a quality learning in such a short span of time. So moving on to the final question of the day, what would you like to say to the prospective BA students? Starting with you, Asif.
So if you are the one who are actually intrigued with the data and you know you want to drive your data insights into different domains, starting from marketing, finance, HR, then surely this domain is for you, this course is for you, and you can actually choose it.
Aishwarya, would you like to add something to it?
Yes, sure. So Asif gave a very apt answer to this question. And yes, if someone who likes to play with the data, draw some insights out of it, and also you have the interest of working in a business field, so I think this course is for you.
This is great to know. So with this, we come to an end of the first episode of In Conversation with SEMHRDN series. Thank you for the wonderful insight. Thank you so much, Asif, and thank you so much, Aishwarya, for sparing your time for this informative series. I'm sure that aspirants will definitely find it helpful. Tune in next week for another insightful discussion. Thank you.